Hi friends, today I discuss about work. So physically, what is work? The first question is, what is work? There is a difference in the way we use the term work in our day-to-day life. In which, in our day-to-day life and by science, there is a lot of difference between work in you, the world used work in day-to-day life and by science. To make this point clear, we take some example. In our daily life, lot of time we say work hard, more work, a lot of work. Let's take an example. If I take example, she reads book, draw diagram, organize her thoughts, collect question paper, and attended class, discuss problem with her friends, and perform experiment. So she expend a lot of energy on this, on all activity, in which some activity mentioned on this. She reads book. Draw diagram. Organizers, collect papers, and perform well. Perform experiments. So these are the activities done by students. And normally say, she expends a lot of energy on this activity. In the common parlance, parents say, and anyone who see done this activity. So normal parlance, she is working very hard. Normally she is working hard. But in all these activity, only little amount of work be done. By scientific definition. So I take some more example. If you push a, let's take this wall. This is a wall. And if you push a wall, like as this. If you push a wall, then after some time, You get completely exhausted. So you think you done very hard work to push the ball. But if the ball not move, then by science or by scientific fact or scientific definition of work, the work done is zero in this activity. So I can say if there is no displacement, then there is no work. So I understand what is the scientific concept of work or what is the scientific work, or the definition of science, definition of work by science. Let's discuss in next page. In previous page, I discussed some activity in which you done no work or some little work, but you think you work very hard and your energy gets exhausted and you get exhausted. Now in this page, I discuss some more activity like a boy pulls a trolley. A boy pulls a trolley and trolley moves. And trolley moves through a distance. And trolley moves through a distance. And some more example. Push a book on table. So in these two activities, scientific work is done or work is done by science. Let's take a close look on this activity. If this is a trolley, and a boy pulls a trolley in this direction, and if trolley moves through some distance, initially the trolley is at A point and after movement trolley on this point. So distance travel is D. So basically in this activity work is done. So if you closely observe this situation, then there are two conditions or we can say there are two conditions need to satisfied for work to be done. So two conditions to the need of the work done. So the first condition is a force should act on object. And the second condition is the object must be displaced. So these two conditions need to be satisfied for work to be done. Let's see in this diagram, these two conditions are fulfilled or not. So the force act on trolley, the first thing, the force act on the trolley by this man. And trolley also displaced from A to B. So these two conditions are fulfilled in this activity, then work is done. So I hope you understand what is this work and what is the scientific concept of work and what is the difference between normally daily saying word work and scientific concept. So please download the Scholar Learning app And if you already download this, then enjoy learning. Thanks for watching this video.